Parenting is a beautiful journey, starting from sleepless nights, midnight feedings, those innocent giggles, smiles, shiny eyes, and then toddler tantrums, reaching milestones, achieving those small things, exploring new objects, starting schools, Monday blues, managing all this is so beautiful. But the word teenage worries the parents most. A period which is of intense growth, especially physical growth, which follows with emotional and behavioral changes, a period that follows the calm and consistent growth of early and middle childhood, a period when we are worried about our child's eating habits, a child's behavior, and most importantly, their happiness. So, hello everyone, this is Dr. Alka Arora, and welcome back to Alka Space. Today's video is about supporting our child at this stage, that is teenage stage. This is a time of changes and challenges for our children. Not only children, but for parents too. Our kids, our children start looking themselves differently at this stage. And it's not just about children. We parents also, we adults also start looking at them very differently. So let us first understand what actually happens at this stage. This is a stage of growth spurt. Now what grows? Actually, it is the intense, a rapid growth of hormones at this stage which brings all these changes. What are hormones? Hormones are powerful chemical substances that are released inside our body from pouches known as endocrine glands. These endocrine glands release hormones in the bloodstream, which are carried throughout the body with the help of blood only. Just as our brain controls our body, brain along with every other part, that is spinal cord and all nerves, that collectively known as nervous system, which controls our body, along with this nervous system, the endocrine system, the system of hormones, coordinates our body functions. These hormones are responsible for all the functions for our body, which work in coordination with the nervous system, that is brain, spinal cord, and neurons. So there are growth hormones, there are sex hormones, there are hormones related to our emotions, anxiety, happiness, everything. There are hormones that are related to our physiological functions, that is digestion, respiration, urination. So in short, these hormones control and coordinate our body functions along with the nervous system. To know more about brain, how it works, there is a complete descriptive video on this very topic only. You can see the link in the description box. Also click on the I button if you want to see how brain works. So let us now move to the changes during the teenage that actually happens. At this stage, sexual maturation is the key factor. This period is a transition from childhood to adulthood. As hormones start playing their roles, the skin becomes oily, acne pop out, mood changes are very normal. Sometimes a child is very happy and sometimes, you know, he or she is just not in mood to talk with anybody. There is a change in eating habits. There is a change in sleeping habits. So all this is very, very, very natural. There is no medication needed. And we all have gone through this stage. So we should understand that this is very, very natural. We should not, you know, think differently about these changes. Since we have become parents, so we, you know, start worrying about. So just go back to your teenage. We also have gone through all this. So we also have experienced. But parenting teenage is a different experience, and this is just about knowing and just about educating yourself and behaving the way our child needs it. It is all about this only. So what actually happens is children develop an individual image about their body. They love talking about their body, their physical appearances, like height, complexion, and other features, their facial features, how they look. And main event at this stage is menstrual cycle. You know, girls have a different range of reactions on this very stage, on this very occurrence. Some girls feel a little surprised, some feel a little suppressed, some feel a little excited, as it is an index to their maturity. So what we as parents need to do is to support them. At this stage, there is a huge pressure. There are different kind of pressures, I should say. There's academic pressure to achieve grades, to achieve more in the school. There's a peer pressure, parental pressure, and pressure related to changes in our body. So children have to handle all these pressures simultaneously. I hope you are getting my point. They have to handle their independence, their urge to get independence, and the pressure that we are creating on them, that we are they have to, you know, handle our pressure also, parental pressure. So the best thing what as parents we can do is reassurance. Reassure your child that this is all natural. You need to stay calm. We all have gone through this phase, and you will also pass this phase very, very beautifully. So now I'm going to discuss seven important tips, seven important points that will help you to make your child's teenage happy. Teenage is the period that is 13 to 19, but it may come early. Teenage is actually this period, but it depends upon the physical maturity. It may come early, like from 11 years, and it, you know, can last longer. The behavioral changes, the changes can last longer up to 20 years also. It depends upon the environment, factors and genetic factors both. So let's start with the points. Number one is acceptance. Accept that your child may get upset. Accept that your child may not agree with your opinions. Accept your child's opinion. Accept your child's interest. Accept that your child loves independence. Accept that your child is changing. Accept that your child is going through so much of physical and emotional changes. So if you will accept, you will able to move forward. You will able to move happily. You will able to have a good atmosphere at your home, which is usually, you know, common problem in Indian houses mainly. Number second is availability. Be available for your child. Be there for your child when he or she wants to talk. Talk and talk to your child. Reschedule your assignments. Reprioritize your preferences. You know, talking to your child and being available to your child is the best way to find out what your child is doing. Let your child know, let your child understand that you are there for her, that you are there for him when he or she needs you the most. So if you are available, he won't look for anybody else outside. So I think you are getting what I'm saying. And number three, answer everything your child asks. Even if the question is not comfortable, you need to answer it. You should answer it. Use simple, correct and comfortable terminology to answer the questions. If you will answer the questions, your child will not search for another modes of answering those questions. You know, at this stage, there is a lot of queries. There are a lot of questions in a child's mind, that what is happening to his or her body, about emotional changes, about the, actually a child lives in a group, in a school group, or he or she goes to tuitions. So he or she perceives so much, he receives so much from the environment, that your child gets curious about the changes. Your child gets curious about the conversations going on in the groups, in school groups, in tuition groups and playgrounds, everywhere. So communicate freely, communicate openly and answer every question your child asks you. Number four is appreciation. Appreciate your child for the efforts. Praise the child for efforts he has put in some works. But here I'll say, do not overpraise your child. Do not take your child to cloud nine. Just a simple appreciative word, a sentence will do. appreciate, learn to appreciate. Do you know, always cross question. Do not always question the capabilities of your child. Number 5 is comparison. Do not ever compare your child with others. Every child has his her own unique identity. Everyone has his or her own capabilities, a set of potentials. So there cannot be, same set of capabilities what your neighbor's child is having. So, and you expect your child to have those set of capabilities. Your neighbor's child is playing basketball. That doesn't mean that your child will also play basketball. Your neighbor's child doesn't like having mobiles. So that doesn't mean that your child is not attracted towards mobile. So do not expect anything that is not possible. So if you want to know more about comparison, if you want to know about disadvantages of comparison, there is a complete video on that also. The link is there is in the description box, and here in the I button you can click here and find out the whole video. Next one is number 6th point is staying calm. Sometimes your child, outburst with anger. This outburst actually causes you to get excited. You also, start arguing. So when both parties argue and you understand what the result is, try to stay calm. Try to listen what your child is saying. Try to let your child do whatever he or she is doing or speaking. Just stay calm. Let the things get over. Let your child stop arguing. Let your child stop whatever she wants to say, whatever she wants to speak. Then talk to your child after he or she returns to normalcy. This is the best way. Arguing never takes you to the solution. It is always, it always complicates the things. So it's better we act as mature person. We are actually much more mature. So it is better to act more mature when we are expected. Number 7 is trust your skills as parents. See, not every family is same. Not everyone's situation is same. Everybody has different set of situations. So there is, no need to follow somebody blindly. Trust yourself as a parent. There is no, we have to act according to our situation. We have to act according to our circumstances. So trust yourself. But if you ever feel like uncomfortable, if you are confused, if you are not sure what to do, talk to school teacher, school counselor, or any other parent you think that he or she possesses skills that you need to learn. So there is no harm in consulting, but trust yourself too. Yes, trusting is very important. You want to protect your child, but your child feels controlled. The child feels that we are being less supportive to him at this stage. So best way is to stay calm, to understand what the child wants. Your role, how you behave influences how the child handles this teenage period, these years. See, if your child sleeps well, eats well, it is more likely that he or she is going to pass this phase very smoothly. But if it is not smooth, it has ups and downs, there is no need to worry. The need is to stay calm, to stay sane, I should say. We should behave like elders. We should behave like mature persons. Most important is to teach them honest, speak truth. This is the most important skill that a child needs to be learned, that needs to get inculcated. So teach your child to be honest, with herself, with himself, to be honest with peers, to be honest with parents, to be honest with teachers. This is the very, very, very important skill. So if you have liked the video, please give a thumbs up and please subscribe to Alka Space for more and more informative videos on parenting. Thank you and have a good day.